Pinedo.
The previous government had also made attempts to try and take the skills agenda forward. The bigger problem or the bigger challenge is that while India may be one of the fastest growing or is the fastest growing economy, growing at about 7.5%, we're still not being able to generate the kind of jobs that we need to. And even when we were growing at 8.5% under the UPA, even then we could not keep pace with the kind of jobs that we needed to. So Mr. Parikar, let me start by asking you, your sector at this point in time is being held up as the sector of great hope. It is being held up as what could be the next big opportunity, specifically on the manufacturing side for India. But this is going to be a sector that will require high-skilled jobs. And since we're talking about high-value and high-skilled, what is it specifically that, for instance, your ministry is doing in partnership with the Skills Mission to try and ensure that we actually have the right kind of people in place?
Before I answer you, I'd like just to add to what you said. It's a dilemma. Whether the employment is available, I don't think employment is that big problem. It's actually employable population that is a big problem. If people are skilled and know how to do certain things, entrepreneur skill or any kind of other skills, in olden generation, this is to be passed on from father to son.
Right.
During last maybe about 30-40 years, the son chooses his field, doesn't necessarily follow what father does. Obviously, those traditional skills have almost died down. Today you face a problem of a good carpenter also. I'm not saying carpenter is a highly paid job, but the deficit exists. A lot of people, if they have a skill, probably they could get employment in this sector. In building industry, for example, you don't get well-trained people. As far as defense is concerned, I think the skill requirement is at the upper end of the scale. Take example, for example, the aviation or the aerospace, where we can have a lot of employment generation. And which I foresee in next maybe couple of years, we should have 2-3 of jet fighter units either operational or about to be operational. Like for example, even the HAL, which has we have successfully developed Tejas, they have been already given the intent for 120 Tejas. And we are in the process of giving them approval for doubling the production line. That is about 16 aircraft per year. We'll have a shortage of skilled manpower. Two more lines in the similar phase and 3-4 helicopter units itself will have a potential of absorbing 50,000 highly skilled jobs. I don't think even just creation of jobs itself will not be enough. So, and in fact, before you actually create job, you should plan your requirement in advance and start skilling up. We have started it.
So, what is the process of being able to develop that pipeline of skilled people? Because as you were pointing out, you know, it's the aerospace business or the aviation sector will require significantly large number of people. And how much of the onus is going to be put on the private players, whether it's domestic or foreign, who come into India to use India as a manufacturing hub to actually partner with the government, and this becomes obligatory on them in some form or fashion?
They don't have to partner with government. For example, the offset regulations can be tweaked in a such a way that skilling can be taken as a part. Training a highly skilled job in the aircraft industry can cost anywhere between 2 lakh per person to 7-8 lakhs,
okay,
depending on the type of job he does. So, if you allow, of course, subject to proper scrutiny and this, skilling as a part of offset obligations.
So, has this necessary tweak already been made a part of the offset policy? That the new offset policy has already been put out?
the existing offset policy has been corrected.
Right.
To take care of the pending issues. The new offset initiative, I will call them initiative, which we are thinking, does include one of the concept as training, skill development, and specialized creation of special knowledge.